One of the great things about the Frontier and the Pursuit, and a great selling point, is that they work really well with motors. Now, there's lots of different type of people that might want to put a motor on a kayak. You got the crowd that wouldn't even consider it without a motor. Then you got people who just kind of like to have that option, you know, hey, maybe someday I'll want to put a motor on. It's nice to be able to do that or know that I can do that easily. You got another group that, you know, wants to expand their range. You know, I want to launch here and be able to go 4 or 5 miles, and paddling that long just isn't going to be much fun. So I want to put a motor on to get to where I want to fish, to, you know, kind of expand my fishing horizons. Then another growing aspect is tournaments, both pre-fishing and using the motors at tournaments. So by using a motor for pre-fishing, you save your energy for tournament day, and there's a growing number of tournaments that are allowing motor use during the tournament. So there's three different types of motors that work great on the Frontier and Pursuit. You have the transom mount trolling motors, you have bow mount trolling motors, and then gas outboards, propane outboards, and I'll lump torpedo in there because it's a high power motor that goes on the transom. So with the transom mount trolling motor, really is your simplest, easiest, quickest solution and most cost effective. You simply drop on the transom mount motor right onto the transom, hook it up to the battery, and away you go. We strongly recommend the use of the transom motor plate both to protect your transom and secure your motor. It prevents it from being able to lift off if your screws come a little bit loose. We also recommend the tiller extension handle to give you full control of the motor from the seat position. And so the transom mount trolling motor is kind of the most basic, simplest, most cost-effective, yet really a great solution. On the thrust, anywhere from 30 to 55 pounds will work just fine. 30-inch shaft length is ideal. It's okay to go up to a 36. The bow mount trolling motor is really kind of the, I'd call it the nicest solution, because you get great power and great control. You can control the bow mount motor with a remote control or a foot pedal. So it's pretty hands-free. You can stand up, you can sit down, you have great control of the motor. And there's some advanced features on the bow mount trolling motors from Motor Guide and Minn Kota. Spot lock, you know, kind of to hold your line. Some of them even have transducer integration for use with the fish finders. So that's a really awesome solution, the bow mount trolling motor. And with that, strongly recommend using the plug and play motor kit to be able to have the battery at the transom end, the stern end of the boat. And this really, you know, the advantages of that, like I said, you got the hands-free control, you got good power, so really it's kind of the best of all worlds. Now the third option is using a gas outboard, or a Lear propane outboard, and even like the Torpedo Travel Series. Now these motors provide great power, but they're not great for control. So we strongly recommend these motors if you're really just launching and using the motor to go from point A to point B. Then you're not using the motor while you're navigating, fishing, getting around. It's just a little bit tricky to be turning those motors on and off and kind of maneuvering in tight spaces. So those motors are great for going long range and then fishing in an area. Now with the transom mount trolling motor and the bow mount trolling motor, we strongly recommend the use of the plug and play motor kit. This is going to be the simplest solution, really easy to get on and off the water, and the best control of the motor. For the transom mount, that includes the tiller extension handle, the transom motor plate, the battery box, the retract cord kit, and best of all, the internal wiring kit. So you simply plug in your motor at the transom, you plug in your battery at the bow, and away you go. You get great weight distribution because the battery is offsetting the motor, and you get a clean, wide open deck with nothing in your way and full control from the seat. With the bow mount trolling motor, the plug and play kit allows you to plug the motor in at the bow, the battery in at the transom, and away you go. It includes the bow mount for the Frontier or Pursuit, different version for each model, the wiring kit, the battery box, and the track strap. So pretty much the kits include everything you need outside of the motor and the battery. Now one other tip when using motors on the Frontier and Pursuit, we strongly recommend plugging the scupper holes. You know, the added weight of the motor and the battery can get you above the self-bailing capacity, and just the force of the motor pushing the boat through the water can draw water in the scuppers. We commonly get people asking, you know, how fast can I go with the trolling motor? Well, with the smaller transom mount motor, you're going to get, 3.5, 4 miles an hour. If you get up to a 55-pound thrust, either on the transom out of the bow mount, you can get 4.5 to 5. And with like an outboard, a Lear, a Torquedo, you know, somewhere in the 5.5 range. You know, so that's the fastest option, like we talked about before, if you're going a long distance, but you don't have quite as good a control. So however you outfit the Frontier, the Pursuit for motors, you can get a really great solution that's going to work really awesome for your customers.